Suzanne, thank you very much for joining me. Suzanne, now the government was saying that those with the broader shoulders should bear the brunt of this, but it seems the middle class seem to be bearing the brunt of all of this. Scarlett thinks it's those who are worst off. Is that your view, or do you have a different opinion on that?
Well, I agree with a lot of what Scarlett said there. I think 9 out of 10 households, if you look at various surveys that have been done on the cost of living crisis, are saying that they are feeling the pinch and finding it very difficult or more difficult to get by. But is the burden falling on the broader shoulders? No, of course it isn't. The fact is, in a cost of living crisis, the wealthiest people in society are really not going to feel the brunt of it very much. The poorest in society, of course, and Charlotte and Scarlett's absolutely right, the increase in food inflation, one of the most fundamental costs for anyone, has gone up so much. I think it's gone up around 15%. And inevitably, that is going to cut into disposable income. Of course it is. But it's those middle classes that really do get squeezed, because there is help out there for the poorest in society. You might argue it's not enough, but the fact is we do have a very good welfare and benefit system in this country. And if you fall below a certain income threshold, you can access quite a lot of support. But if you're middle class, it's much more difficult. So, for instance, we've now got, I think, around 6 million people who have now been pushed into a higher tax bracket, into the 40% tax bracket in the past few years. That's the biggest number we've ever had, because it hasn't really kept pace with inflation. So more of those people are going to be paying more tax, but not really feeling the benefit of being in that higher tax bracket. We also know that even when you look at people...
Let's bring Scarlett back in. Suzanne, let's bring Scarlett back in, because I want to bring you both back in. Because Scarlett was saying that actually she thinks that the worst off are hit the worst. I don't tend to agree with that. I think that the middle class are hit worse. Frankly, because those worst off actually have help out there, as Suzanne was saying. I mean, would you not hear that?
They don't have a lot of help. I mean, we're talking about people like nurses going to food banks. We're talking, I mean, food banks no longer have enough food, because the people who used to give money to food banks are now going to them. So we're not just talking about people on benefits. We're talking about people who really don't earn very much money. And the gas, the electricity, the food, their rent. You know, I mean, remember, the rent goes up. If the landlords have to pay more money, the rent goes up. I mean, it just isn't. Of course, the middle classes will be hit. And they
I think you slightly proved your own point, though. As you said, the middle classes are now the ones going to the food banks as well. And not only that, but they'll be hit in several places as well. Suzanne, I mean, in my view, who do you think is worse to hit with this? Do you think it's the middle class, or do you think it's the poorer that are hit, even though they spend a larger portion of their income? Those in the middle don't get anything. They don't get any help.
I mean, I think it is, in this particular crisis, definitely the middle classes. And I'd argue that nurses are probably middle class, actually, to be honest. You know, some nurses' salaries hit that middle class bracket. You're more senior in the NHS. You can be on a potentially extremely good salary. And of course, some nurses actually do private sector, private hospital work as well, to boost their NHS salary, and they're allowed to do that. So I don't think that's the best example, to be honest. What we're finding is food banks, anecdotally, are saying that the people who used to be bringing in food to the food banks are now the ones actually coming in and needing that support. Even people earning £60,000 plus a year, which might seem like a large salary, are struggling. There's been a 13% increase in approaches to debt helplines from people earning more than £60,000 a year. And if you think about it, if you set yourself a certain lifestyle, you might have public school education for your children, you might have a commute that's expensive, because you live quite a distance away from where you work. You've perhaps got a bigger home, so you've got bigger energy bills, your mortgage has gone up, your rent is likely to be higher. I'm not saying that we aren't all struggling, but I think for the middle-class families, it must have come as a heck of a shock. And if you're having to sort of make a decision about whether to sell your home because you can no longer afford the mortgage, take your child out of the school that they're very happy at, it's not a pleasant situation whatsoever.